Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Peony here. Today we're talking all about denim. So if you want to hear all of my top denim tips, favorite brands and styles, just keep watching. So guys, let's get straight into the video. I've got all of my favorite denim here. Kit said as I was laying it out, she's like, that's so much. And I was like, this is literally not even half the denim I own. I'm a big denim fan, so I've tried a lot of brands and a lot of styles, so hopefully I'm going to be able to give you guys some tips and tricks from it. First of all, I'm going to talk you through all of my favourite styles and kind of core denim types, and then I'm going to tell you the brands, and then we can talk about some styling at the end. Very beginning of all denim, which for everyone has got to be a classic black skinny jean, right? That's like the core of most people's closet. Very difficult thing to find a good one of. They tend to wash out very quickly. The black fades, the fit can go, you get baggy knees. So many issues with the black denim. This particular style and brand were recommended to me by my girlfriend Steph. I will link her down below. She's fabulous and she's just started a food blog. So these are from L'Argence, I think that's how you say it. My French is awful, as we've established in previous videos. And they're basically really thick but soft black stretch denim. They're high-waisted, this style, and I just love them. The fit is really, really great, and they hold their fit. They don't go loose at the knee, and they hold their dye as well. So all in all, I've been really thrilled with these. I bought these in a 26. My denim sizes fluctuate quite a bit. I wear everything from a 25 to a 27, so there's quite a lot of variation there, but these ones I bought in a 26. The next pair of jeans, so I actually own about 5 pairs from this brand, but I only brought a couple out to show you because I wanted you to see kind of some variation. This brand is called Frame. It's one of my favourite denim brands. I have them in sizes 25 to 27. It kind of depends on the style and how I want it to fit. So if I want them to be super tight, I go 25, 26. If I want them to be a bit looser and more casual, I go 27. So these are in a 26. These are one of my favourite, most worn pairs of jeans. Frame are quite expensive, and because I know the sizing and the styles that I like from Frame, I can buy them on Vestiaire sometimes and on eBay secondhand because I know what I want from the brand. If you haven't bought them before, I would recommend going in store. Go to Harrods, go to Selfridges, try them on in person just to kind of figure out what your sizing is before you buy secondhand ones, just in case they're not quite right. But this is my favourite denim band. A, I find them super, super comfortable. B, I love the washes and the fits. They do a proper crop, a proper skinny, you know, all of the styles are actually what they say they are. They really fit. They've got a really good amount of stretch, so they never go baggy on the knee, but they're also thick enough to look like a quality jean. Like this grey, I've actually pulled 2 pairs of grey jeans from them for you to see because, see, they even do like variations on grey. Like these are completely different grey shades, and yet, very different, very important when you're wearing them, which grey you go for. You get them with rips, without rips, the whole deal. So I love this brand. This is one of my favourites. The style that I tend to buy the most from them is called Le Skinny de Jean. So that's the style I like best. Now, I kind of get that not everyone wants to spend 200, you know, 150 on a pair of jeans. I get that because it's a big investment. So my favourite pair of high street jeans that I've probably bought the most of are these. These are the H&M super skinny, super low waist jeans. Now, these come with a caveat. They are great and I've worn them a lot and they are really good for tucking into boots because they're quite thin and stretchy and they stay really skinny. I've got really skinny ankles and they actually stay skinny, but the only issue I have with them is that the fabric is quite thin, which, like I said, if you're tucking them into boots, it's really a good thing. But if you need a bit more hold, you're not going to get it from these jeans because they are quite thin. So you're going to see lumps and bumps. So if you're still working on that Pilates body, probably don't go with a cheaper high street jean. A cheaper high street jean can be really good. I've bought really good ones in the past from Zara and Mango before as well. But they are very hit and miss and you have to try them on yourself. These are the only kind of standard jean style that I found from a high street brand that's very consistent and I've been able to buy online afterwards. So I've worn these in a 27-30. Because they are low slung, I tend to find that I need to go up a size because they're sitting on my hips, not my waist. So yeah, so these are a 27. So we talked about this pair of jeans in my 10 fundamentals video. I will link it here for you. If you saw that, you will have already heard about this pair of jeans, but I wanted to talk about it again in this video. So these are the classic Levi's 501. So I spoke to you about this style here with the rips in, but I also own them in black, and I actually customized the bottoms. I just chopped the bottoms off to make them cropped and frayed. So this style, I really, really love this style. And basically, you know all of those jeans that everyone's been wearing that are like Redons and expensive mother brands and stuff where it is made to look like a vintage Levi's? This is the actual Levi jean that that's based on, pretty much. And they're much cheaper if you just buy them direct from Levi's. So I will link that below for you guys. So I wear these in, I think they're a 26. That's my favourite of the kind of Levi's original style jean. And they're really quite affordable. However, if you do have the money all the time, you can go for either a true vintage Levi's from a vintage store or a redone Levi's, which are vintage Levi's that redone, recut, and like recustomized to make them more modern. I have bought both of those, and the only thing I would say about buying both those styles of jean are it's very difficult to buy a single pair. You have to go and try a lot of different styles and colours on because the washes vary, the fits vary slightly, and it's all about finding that perfect fit. So these are two of the vintage pairs that I've found in the past. One pair, this one, I've customised myself. I've put the rips in, I've cut the bottoms off, and I've done a little bit on the back pocket as well. And these are just an old pair of Levi's that I found in a vintage store and I liked the fit of. They were high-waisted, they're like loose on the thigh, but they're nice and fitted on the waist. It was a kind of relaxed mum style jean that I felt I could customize into a crop. So that's why I bought those. And then these are a super fitted, high-waisted pair of jeans. So these are like a 24, I want to say. The things rubbed off on the inside, but they are small, these jeans, and they look amazing on, but there's no room for sandwiches. So, but you would only find a fit like that by traipsing through a vintage store. There are so many vintage stores in London, in New York, in LA, all over the place. Paris has loads that you can find vintage Levi's in. It's just a matter of like spending the time to find a good fit. You can also do what I recommend, which is buying like 5 to 10 styles from Urban Outfitters of their vintage Levi's and then just trying them all on and returning the wrong ones, because then you can basically do it at home and it's the same experience. Because it really is, each pair is so unique, you kind of can't just buy one. That's how you end up with a fit that you're not quite happy with. So that's how I recommend to buy vintage jeans. It's kind of less of a style that I wear now, but I wore it a huge amount when I was first on the scene and first kind of blogging. And that's a flare, a high-waisted flare. And I used to wear them all the time with like Chloe-esque kind of chiffon blouses. I do still have them and I do wear them occasionally. I normally tend to wear them more in the winter, strangely. These, again, are from Frame Denim. They're high-waisted. These are their La Flair de Frame jeans in black. They have these nice big pockets. They're really comfortable. I love a flare. They're very flattering flares. If you're not comfortable with a skinny, if you want to wear a heel in everyday life, if you like wearing a boot more and you find that, you know, the kind of ratio of your calf doesn't look right, these are all concealed within the flare. So I do really recommend experimenting with flares if you're not comfortable with jeans in general, because they tend to be a style that is more flattering and more comfortable for most body types. It's an easy way to kind of add height as well into your silhouette. It's really worth going and figuring out which style you like for yourself. But for me, it's high-waisted, and these I bought in a size 26. The last piece of denim that I think is probably a fundamental in anyone's denim wardrobe is a white pair of jeans. I have more than one white pair of jeans, but I'm really picky about them. So these are the ones that I got out to show you. These are J Brand, and they've got nice rips down the front. I also have ones that have kind of the traditional thick Levi's denim with cropped ankles. I have ones that have no rips in. But the main thing to look out for with white denim is quality and density to the denim. If you can see through them, if you can see the pockets through them when they're on you, that means that denim is not a good enough quality denim. That's too thin, not flattering. You'll be able to see your pants through it. You're going to be able to see all your lumps and bumps. You don't want that. You want a nice, sturdy, thick white denim to be more flattering and hold you in. J Brand did really good white denim. These are actually quite old now, but I was a big fan of J Brand and their denim. These are in a size 28. So I went for quite a loose fit with these because they're almost like a mom jean with the rips and stuff, and I do the ankle sock. So they're not skinny jeans. They probably would have been if I bought them in the correct size, but I wanted them to be a much looser fit. I do have tight skinny white jeans as well, but again, just be careful with the fit and make sure the quality of the denim is really up there, because otherwise you're going to end up with that kind of semi-transparency, which doesn't look cute at all. So those are the different brands and styles that I like and kind of where I get the different styles from. So when it comes to styling, it's kind of a completely different thing. With denim, most of your styling is going to be in your belt and in what you do to the ankle area. So I often figure out what else is going on in the outfit, what shoes I'm wearing, and then at the end I'll style the jeans so that I know kind of where the balance of the outfit's going to be. If I'm wearing something that I need to see ankle, naturally I'm going to create a shorter length to the leg of the jean, and I'm naturally going to want to roll so that I create that little bit of kind of skinniness at the ankle. Now there's the normal way to roll jeans, whereby you just fold them twice like that. That's like a traditional fold. The other way you can roll them is to roll them up twice the height and then in a half, so that you still see the edge of the denim, which can be a nice change. Sometimes I also roll inside if I want a cleaner edge and I don't want to see the roll, which can be good when you just need to alter the length a little bit. I roll inside like this so that you don't see any of the fold. It really depends on what shoes you're wearing and what style you're going for, but those are the kind of three folds that I do around the ankle. Obviously you can make them thinner, smaller, whatever. Whether I wear a belt with a pair of jeans or not has a massive amount to do with the top and how much of the belt you're going to see. You know, if you're wearing something where you can see the button of the jeans, then you need to wear a belt 9 times out of 10, because often it can look quite empty without. Sometimes a jean with literally a single buckle belt, I'll link some below, that can be the best thing because it's just so comfortable, it looks like part of the jean, and it just kind of brings the outfit together in a very subtle way. Other times you need to make more of a focus and a statement with the buckle area, and I tend to go for more masculine belts. So I'm the kind of person that likes a bit more hardware on my belt. I like, you know, a little bit of studding or some metal clasps, that kind of thing, just to add a little bit of toughness to the jean. That tends to be my aesthetic with denim. So that's kind of the key to how I style my denim. Those are really the two things I think about when I'm wearing denim. So I hope that's helpful for you guys. Also, leave me a comment below. I'd love to hear your denim recommendations. Like Steph recommended this black pair to me. It's so great to hear from you guys, any brands or styles that are working really well for you. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up below. I'd love to hear from you. And also, if you want to see more content, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell, because then you'll get notified every time I publish a new video. Thanks so much for watching this one, guys, and I'll see you again next week. Bye.